हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस चैप्टर 5 ऑफ क्लास 12 बायोलॉजी, दैट इज प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस एंड वेरिएशन। वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिवाइडेड दिस चैप्टर इन टू पार्ट्स एंड इन पार्ट वन वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस वेरियस लॉज ऑफ मेंडल, कोडोमिनेंस, मल्टीपल एलील्स एक्सेट्रा। नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रेस्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक्स। फर्स्ट मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इज क्रोमोसोमल थ्योरी ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस। दिस एज वी नो दैट मेंडल पब्लिश हिज वर्क ऑन इनहेरिटेंस ऑफ कैरेक्टर इन 1865, बट फॉर सेवरल रीजन इट रिमेन अनरिकग्नाइज्ड। फर्स्टली दिस कम्युनिकेशन वॉज नॉट सो ईजी इन दोज डेज। सेकेंडली हिज कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ जीन्स और फैक्टर्स एज स्टेबल और डिस्क्रीट यूनिट्स दैट कंट्रोल द एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ ट्रेट वॉज नॉट एक्सेप्टेड। And third, mental approach of using mathematics to explain biological phenomena was totally new and it was unacceptable to many of the biologists. So Mendel's work suggested that factors or genes, they were discrete units, and he could not provide any physical proof for the existence of these factors. So in In 1900, three scientists, that is De Vries, Correns and Trishikmar, they rediscovered Mendel's laws. And by that time, there were various advancements in microscopy technique, and it led to carefully observation of cell division. That is, cell division can be observed by this microscopy. Now this led to the discovery of various structures, and the nucleus was one of them that appeared to be double layered structure and it divide just before cell division. So they named these structures as chromosomes. In 1902, chromosome movement during meiosis had been worked out, and other scientists like Sutton and Boveri noted that the behavior of chromosomes was parallel to the behavior of genes, and he used chromosomal movement to explain the Mendel laws. The important thing to remember is that chromosomes also, as well as genes, they occur in pairs, and the two alleles of gene pair are located on homologous chromosomes. And this homologous chromosomes means that two alleles of a gene pair which are located on homologous sites, they are known as homologous chromosomes. Very famous scientists Sutton and Boveri argued that pairing and segregation of the pair of chromosomes, this lead to segregation of factors like genes. Now they also united the knowledge of chromosomal segregation with Mendelian principles, and it was called as chromosomal theory of inheritance, because chromosome was also involved with the rediscovery of Mendel's laws. Following this synthesis of ideas, verification of chromosomal theory was done by Morgan and his colleagues, and it led to the discovery of various variation and sexual reproduction produced. Now Morgan also worked with tiny fruit fly, that is Drosophila melanogaster, and found that it was suitable for this study, for genetic study. So this Drosophila melanogaster was widely used for genetic study. They could be grown on simple synthetic medium in the lab. This is also one of the factor why he used Drosophila. And next was that they complete their life cycle in 2 weeks, and a single mating could produce a large number of progeny. Thus, it was a clear differentiation of two sexes, that is male and female sex can be easily distinguished. So this is the diagram which is showing G1, G2, meiosis, meiosis 2 and germ cells. By that time, due to environment's advancement in the microscopy, cell division was seen, and this is the various stages of cell division and germ cell formation, and these are germ cells. And chromosomes can be seen. When this chromosome segregation can be seen when the germ cells are formed. Now next is linkage and recombination. This linkage, when two genes in a dihybrid cross were situated on same chromosome, the proportion of parental gene combination was much higher than the non-parental gene type. Morgan attributed this physical association with the linkage of two genes and coined the term linkage to describe the physical association of genes on the same chromosome. So this physical association of genes on the same chromosome was known as linkage, and this term was coined by Morgan. Now the generation of non-parental gene combination during dihybrid cross is known as recombination. When genes are located on the same chromosome, they are tightly linked and show very little or very low recombination. So this is one of most important statement, that when the genes are located on the same chromosome, they are tightly linked. When the genes are tightly linked, they show very low recombination as compared to when the genes are not tightly linked. For example, the genes for white and yellow, they are tightly linked and they show only 1.3% of recombination, while the genes for white and miniature showed 37.2% of recombination. This is because when the genes are tightly linked, they show very little recombination. Now his students, Alfred, used the frequency of recombination between the gene pairs on the same chromosome as a measure of distance between the genes and mapped their position on the chromosome. So this was done with the help of genetic maps. With the help of genetic map, the distance was measured. So today genetic maps are extensively used as the starting point in sequencing of genomes. And this sequencing of genomes was done in case of human genome sequencing project. So in human genome sequencing project, the genomes of various organisms was tracked and it was made available in this human genome sequencing project, and this was done with the help of genetic maps. This is the diagram showing the crosses between A and B. This is parental. In F1 generation, we can see that wild type and yellow is appeared, and further gametes. These are the gametes, and this is recombinant type, that is 1.3%, and parental type 98.7%. But in this case, that is cross B, we can see that parental type is 62.8% and recombinant is 37.2%. While in F2 generation, it was seen that yellow, white and yellow was obtained, and white miniature and white was obtained. So this is the diagram showing the linkage, that is results of two dihybrid crosses which was conducted by Morgan. And cross A shows that crossing between gene Y and W, and cross B shows crossing between W and M. So here dominant wild type alleles are represented with plus sign. Now we should know what is the difference between the crossing over and linkage. So there are some differences between crossing over and linkage. In case of crossing over, it leads to separation of linked gene, whereas in linkage, it keeps the gene together. So this is one of the differences. Second, crossing over involves exchange of segments between non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosome, whereas in linkage, it involves individual chromosomes. Third, the frequency of crossing over can never exceed 50%. But in case of linkage, the number of linkage group can be more than haploid number of chromosome. And last, crossing over, it increases the variability by forming new gene combination, whereas in case of linkage, it reduces the variability. So these are the four differences you should know between the crossing over and linkage. Now, another term is sex determination. Henking in 1891 observed a trace of specific nuclear structure in few insects. He observed that specific nuclear structure is located on 50% of sperms only. So he called it as X body, and he was not able to explain its significance. Now later it was observed that ovum that received the sperms with X body become female and not males. So X body was known as sex chromosome and other chromosomes were known as autosomes. So this was the scientist Henking. He observed that X body was known as sex chromosome and apart from X body, other chromosomes were known as autosomes. In humans and other organisms, XY type of sex determination is seen. And in some insects like Drosophila, XO type of sex determination is present. In both types of sex determination, the male produces two different types of gametes, with or without X chromosome, and some with X chromosome, and some with Y chromosome. Such types of sex determination is called male heterogamety. In birds, ZW type of sex determination is present, that is two different types of gametes are produced by females in terms of sex chromosome. This type of sex determination is known as female heterogamety. Sex determination in human being is XY type. Now out of 23 pairs of chromosome, 22 pairs are exactly same in male and female and these are known as autosome and one is sex chromosome. So out of 23 pairs, 22 are autosome and one is sex chromosome. A pair of X chromosome is present in female and XY in male. During spermatogenesis, male produces two types of sperm. 50% carries Y chromosome and remaining 50% carries X chromosome. So female produce only one type of gamete, that is ovum, having X chromosome only. Now the sperm with Y chromosome, if it is having Y chromosome, the sex of the baby is male. And when the sperm is carrying X chromosome, it will fertilize with the X and the sex of the baby will be female. So it is the sex of the baby depends on Y and X chromosome. When Y chromosome is present, it will be male, and when X chromosome fertilizes the egg, the sex will be female. This is the diagram showing the XY and XX. XY means this is male and XX means this is female. So both in humans and Drosophila, the female has a pair of XX chromosome and male is having XY chromosome, which is heterogametic. Now next topic is genetic mutation. Mutation is a phenomena which results in alternation of DNA sequence and it consequently results in change in genotype and phenotype of an organism. So this mutation can result in the change in genotype and phenotype of organism because it is changing the alternation, it is changing the DNA sequence. The mutation can give rise to change in single base pair of DNA and it is known as point mutation. Example is sickle cell anemia. And when it deletes an insertion of base pair of DNA, this results in frame shift mutation. There are and certain chemicals are there or physical factors that can induce mutations. So these chemicals or physical factors that can cause mutation are known as mutagens. UV radiations are responsible for causing mutation in various organisms. So it is a mutagen because it is causing mutation in various organisms. Now due to these mutations, there are various genetic disorders. First genetic disorder is pedigree analysis. Now the analysis of traits in several of generation of a family is pedigree analysis. So the analysis of trait which is done in several generation of family, it is pedigree analysis. Inheritance of particular trait is represented in a family tree over several generation. And this pedigree analysis is used to trace the inheritance of a particular trait or abnormality or disease. So any inheritance of particular trait or any abnormality or disease, it can be traced or tracked by pedigree analysis. These are the symbols which are used for male, female, sex, affected individuals, matings. So the symbols used in pedigree analysis are these. Now broadly, genetic disorders can be grouped into two categories. First is Mendelian disorders and second is chromosomal disorders. In Mendelian disorders, there are various disorders like hemophilia and sickle cell anemia. First, we will study hemophilia. Hemophilia, sex-linked recessive disease. It is a sex-linked recessive disease in which an infected individual, a minor cut leads to non-stop bleeding. So in this hemophilia, a minor cut can lead to non-stop bleeding. In heterozygous female, that is carrier, it can transmit the disease to their son. The possibility of female becoming hemophilic is extremely rare because mother of such female has to be a least carrier and father should be hemophilic. Now another disease is sickle cell anemia. And sickle cell anemia is an autosome-linked recessive trait in which mutant hemoglobin molecules undergo polymerization under low oxygen tension, causing the change in the shape of RBCs from biconvex to elongated sickle cell structure. And because of this sickle cell structure, this disease is known as sickle cell anemia. Now, this defect is caused by substitution of glutamic acid by valine at the sixth position of beta globin chain of hemoglobin molecule. The substitution of amino acid in the globin protein results due to single base substitution at the 6th codon of beta globin gene from GAG to GUG. These are the diagram showing the sickle cell anemia. Next disease is phenylketonuria. It is an inborn error of metabolism, inherited or autosomal recessive trait. The inherited individual lack an enzyme that converts the amino acid phenylalanine to tyrosine. So this is a disease in which the individual lack an enzyme that converts phenylalanine to tyrosine. As a result of this, phenylalanine is accumulated and it is converted into phenylpyruvic acid and other derivatives. And this disease leads to mental retardation. So this is because of the absence of particular enzyme that converts phenylalanine to tyrosine. Now, what are chromosomal disorders? Failure of segregation of chromatids during cell division results in loss or gain of chromosome, and this is known as aneuploidy. Now, failure of cytokinesis leads to two set of chromosomes. These is known as polyploidy. So, chromosomal disease results because there is failure of segregation of chromatids during the cell division. First disease is Down syndrome. Down syndrome is due to presence of additional copy of chromosome number 21. The affected individual has various structures, like the affected individual is short statured with small rounded head, furrowed tongue and partially open mouth. And second, mental development is retarded. So this is the diagram showing the Down syndrome. Next is Klinefelter syndrome. It is due to presence of additional copy of X chromosome. So the chromosome becomes XXY. Such persons have overall masculine development. The feminine development is also expressed. And they are mostly sterile. Third is Turner syndrome. It is caused due to absence of one of the chromosome 45 with XO. Such females are sterile and ovaries are rudimentary. They lack secondary characters. So they also lack secondary characters. Please subscribe my video and press the bell icon so that we can bring more videos for your revision.